we can be free.
Cześć moi drodzy, niedługo na moim kanale pojawi się seria pod tytułem Tajemnice i ciekawostki z Counter-Strike Global Offensive. Dziś zapraszam Was do obejrzenia pierwszego odcinka z tej serii i oczywiście do zostawienia łapeczki w górę. Pierwszym graffiti upamiętniającym niesamowitą, wręcz niezwykłą akcję pro playera jest to graffiti. Nie bez przyczyny strzeliłem tutaj no-scope'em w to miejsce, ponieważ jest to akcja upamiętniająca akcję Simpla z meczu Team Liquid kontra Fnatic. Był wtedy wynik 9-4 i Simple, czyli wtedy jeszcze zawodnik Team Liquid, ugrał klacza 1-2 z samą AWP-ą. Zdobył dwa fragi, nie używając lunety w AWP-ie, czyli po prostu no-scope'em. Komentatorzy byli bardzo zaskoczeni tą akcją i zachwyceni, więc autor mapy postanowił dodać takie oto graffiti. Zresztą zobaczcie je sami. Simple is creeping. They see him with the AWP now and the desperate play into B comes in. Smokes. You see a double smokes in the same place there. Simple just jumping casually into the side. He's gonna fall down again. What is this clap from Simple? Are you serious? What is that? You can't do that, Simple. That's not allowed. This is not FPL. This is a major. Simple, I don't know, man. If he just comes in with that, there's nothing. That was a no-scope! It was a no-scope! He didn't even... He had one button on his mouse stand. He had one button. There was no zoom. Kolejna niesamowita akcja miała miejsce na mapie Demiraż. Nową sajcie B. Akcją popisał się Coldzera w meczu Team Liquid kontra Luminosity Gaming były, czyli obecny SK Gaming. Można powiedzieć, że tą akcją tylko przedłużył mecz Team Liquid kontra LG wtedy, ponieważ i tak Team Liquid wygrał ten mecz. Komentatorzy nie kryli zaskoczenia i naprawdę, zobaczcie sami.
The team now going back to Old Faithful and Cold might be in trouble.
Yeah, there's a lot of pressure on him. He's got to hit these shots. We saw falling in this spot before, the same spot, but with much more utility to work with. Here he comes once again. The first base is a trend. He's going to hit the ground there as Cold. Oh,
what?
A jumping double from Cold. What is there going on right now? How does he do this? Cold has saved Luminosity with the AWP play. Unthinkable scenes there on the B apartments.
Na mapie DDoS 2, na respie terrorystów, znajduje się takie oto graffiti. Widać na nim terrorystę trzymającego 4 AWP. Dlaczego 4? No to zobaczcie to sami. Komentatorzy nie kryli zdziwienia. Nie kryli zdziwienia i nawet w sumie to było nawet śmieszne.
Nanosecond kill and look at the guns. Four AWPs. Fnatic, they're ready to shoot some ducks as they cross the middle. It's going to be a challenge and Apex not in this lifetime. He is destroyed. Well.
Następny graffiti upamiętnia akcję, która pokazuje, że w Counter-Strike'u bardzo ważne jest szczęście. Olofmeister, rozbrajając bombę w Mołotowie, zginął w ostatniej sekundzie jej rozbrajania, lecz zdążył ją rozbroić. Komentatorzy byli bardzo zdziwieni tą sytuacją i nie kryli swojego zdziwienia.
How many of them looking like I'm going to finish? Has got his foot in towards the site. Pronax finds Zipnix, not the best of starts. Flusher gets Dupree bomb, is going down. Device still kicking as Fetish waits and finds himself a little bit of smoke to hide in, but it's a 2v4 and it's going to be desperately hard to hold on to. Device around the world we go, but the defuse is coming in. He's still going. Oh, Olof just about gets it. Flames come in and look at the little dance of happiness. That is how to control your nerves in a situation. Dance it out.
Ostatnią już akcję na dziś nie upamiętnia graffiti, lecz znak. Dlaczego wstawiłem to do odcinka z graffiti? Ponieważ jest to najbardziej znana rzecz na mapie The Overpass, którą zrobił jakikolwiek pro player. Na znaku jest oczywiście napisane: nie wspinać się na wysokości,
chyba każdy wie dlaczego. Powstała tutaj nawet miejscówka, tak zwany The All of Pass. No i właśnie, zobaczcie sami. Able to force it up here, but it won't be too impressive again. We don't see the AWPs, we don't see the Molotovs either, so they are a little bit limited in how elaborate they can execute here in the 20th round. Auto sniper picked up on the Lockmeister, and now I'm just wondering, is this going to be the case? Is he going to try and shoot through, or is he just going to look down there? All right,
it's happening again. It's happening again. Let's see. I mean, do they give it away? Do they use it here? I mean, he hasn't even shown that he can use it towards top mid like this. Fnatic, I mean, LDS, he could run right through here. They may have never... Wait, are they jumping around trying to check?
No, I think he's just jumping. There it is. All of that. He's raining down death from above. He's essentially just a god picking people out. Look at this field of view. He might as well be in a helicopter above the map at this point, just sniping people.
This is
cruel and unusual punishment, without a doubt, from all of the LPLC. This is torture. They've got to be wondering what the hell is going on. Are they going to get killed up here as well? He spotted MBK. If he gets a kill at this angle too, then are they just all going to report him? Is that the ultimate outcome here? He's Mutt Smith down there as well, but the push is going to be for A right now. Grenade on down, and it does hit Smith for 52 damage. JW follow up with a double kill. LDLC.
What do you do in this scenario when you had everything? You had the wind in your sails, and they just shredded them. There is no hope anymore. Olafmeister, once again, going to be put up here. Is he fast enough, however, to stop this? Is he gonna...